Dear friends of the Tom Foyle channel and the new viewers alike. In today's episode, we are investigating how to properly sharpen images with GIMP. GIMP is a free, powerful, and hugely popular tool for photo manipulation that offers free alternative to Adobe Photoshop. I use GIMP for most of my JPEG work, just like I use RAW Therapy for RAW files. See the link to my RAW Therapy video below. I think most JPEG images out of a camera need to be sharpened a bit. The trick is to be gentle about it and not overdo it. Oversharpening can effectively ruin your photo, just like applying makeup. If it's used so that you don't notice it, then it can improve things. If you see it clearly, you're over the top in the wrong direction. My current version of GIMP is 2.10.18. It is the latest at the moment. Earlier versions of GIMP had sharpen and unsharpen mask as two options to sharpen images. It didn't make sense to use sharpen because it was too rough. And now the two have been combined, or more accurately, the simple sharpen has been lost entirely. No regrets here. So we're using unsharp mask to sharpen images. Let's first load a quick photo that I took for this exercise just a few days ago. Now let's pull up the unsharp mask. You'll find it under filters and then under enhance. Let's go over what's in the unsharpen mask window. The first field stores your sharpening history in case you want to apply a preset from an earlier sharpening session. At the bottom, you have two tick boxes. The preview toggles between the sharpened and original image. This is very useful for seeing how much effect your sharpening has. The split view shows sharpened and original image side by side. This is less useful because it shows different parts of the image and it's more difficult to understand what happened. The key things are radius, amount, and threshold. What are they? The radius indicates how wide the region is around the edge that you are going to sharpen. The default is 3, which means 3 pixels wide in both directions from edge. This is too wide for most images. I generally find myself staying between 1 and 2. The second parameter, the amount, sets the strength of sharpening, how different you want to make the neighboring pixels when you sharpen, how steep you want the gradient to be when comparing left and right side of the sharpening edge, so to speak. Here the default is 0.5, and this is a good number. I'd recommend to stay right at 0.5 for most purposes. Threshold, the third parameter, has to do with what is defined as the edge that is going to be sharpened. If the number is small, GIMP sees edges everywhere. If the number is large, GIMP only wants to sharpen the most prominent edges. This is a very important slider. If you set it to 0, everything is sharpened. You get sharpened edges even in the middle of blue sky, and you'll create grain. If you make it large, you just add sharpness to the most important edges. I generally like to sharpen just the main edges. Let's now systematically figure out the best settings. Here I'm using a photo of sky and trees, 24 megapixels. This is a good choice because you'll want your object, such as the tree branches, to be sharp, but you won't want to make your sky grainy. Another good choice to show would be skin and eyes. The eye borders need to be nice and sharp, but skin needs to stay smooth. For this exercise, I've isolated just a tiny part of the image so that we could zoom in to more than 100% to really see what's happening. The numbers behind the pictures are in the same order as they appear in the GIMP window: radius, amount, and threshold. Here, we are playing with the first one, the radius. Going from left to right and top to bottom, we increase the sharpening radius. The first image, top left, is the original one. A good radius is under 3, so we are going to more extremes here to see it better. You see the details go away as we include more pixels for sharpening. It's almost like you're creating an oil painting version of the image when you compare the original image and the radius 9 in the bottom right. The bottom right is clearly overdoing it. The higher the resolution of your image in pixels, the larger radius values you should be using. Now let's look at the second parameter, the amount. This is essentially multiplying your sharpening effect by some constant. Small differences are being exaggerated as you increase this slider. A typical normal value is 0.5. If you make it 0, you're not going to see an effect. If you push it to the right, you'll see what's in the bottom right. There the picture looks like a pencil drawing. Please note that we use a rather large radius value of 3 and unnaturally low threshold value of 0 to exaggerate the effects so that we could see it better. Under normal circumstances, the amount slider would show less effect. Now this is looking at the third parameter, the threshold. This is a way to tell GIMP not to sharpen the edges that are not prominent enough. Only sharpen where it matters the most. This is a good way to avoid producing grain in the image. The effects are not incredibly visible because we are using kind of normal settings for the other parameters here. And this is on purpose because with this slider, I'd like to show the normal behavior. The upper right image has threshold value at 0, meaning that maximal number of edges are being sharpened. The bottom right has the slider at 0.4, and here only the most obvious edges are sharpened. You probably see that the bottom right image appears more natural than the upper right. Again, we're working with much enlarged images here, because then we see the effects better. I made a summary table for you to generate more concrete take-home messages. The first column is the ranges that I would consider under normal circumstances. The second column is where I would most typically look when sharpening. And the last column shows you the settings that I use most of the time for my photos. Now a disclaimer or a small print. This table is based on my opinion and my experience and holds for a typical 24 megapixel landscape image. Every photographer has their own best settings. Different conditions require different sharpening approach. For example, you may want to deviate from this table a lot if you have a camera shake situation and you want to simply rescue an image to make it kind of usable. In that case, you'll want to go to extreme with some of the settings. Here's an example where I misfocused an image, but I liked it so much that I decided to rescue it with some extreme sharpening. Let me show you a section of our landscape image as an original, sharpened the way I typically sharpen it, and also sharpened with a bit extreme settings, where I think we have gone over the top. I personally like the middle image. You will want to play with the GIMP sharpening settings to find out what the middle means for you. And I hope my presentation here gave you a good starting point for this. And the last important note, sharpening should be done as the last step during photo manipulation. Especially when you resize your image, then sharpen the image only after you've done resizing. Thank you so much for checking out the Tom Photo channel. I hope to see you again in my future and past videos where I talk about photography-related matters and share my experience. Have a great day.